how you love him.
That's how you love him.
Wherever you are, you can kneel down.
Sweet, and the courage to dream has turned incomplete. Oh my, at the altar your brokenness he will meet.
Oh,
there's joy in knowing he's
near. I greet the church in the wonderful name of our Lord and soon coming King Jesus, and would like to take this time to welcome you to our midweek prayer meeting, the intention of which is just to share a short devotion and we pray together. And for this evening's devotion, we read together from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17. 1 Samuel chapter 17, and we read together verse 22. And I read it in the New American Standard Bible, and it reads as follows. Then David left his baggage in the care of the baggage keeper and ran to the battle line and came and greeted his brothers. Then David left his baggage in the care of the baggage keeper and ran to the battle line and came and greeted his brothers. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Let us pray together. Our God and our Father in heaven, we want to thank you for the reading of your word, and we pray that for the next few minutes, you may speak to us in a way that you'd want us to know and understand you. In Christ's name we have prayed. Amen. 1 Samuel chapter 17 is a popular text. We all know it. It's the story of David and Goliath. But I want us to start before David reaches the battlefield, before he arrives at the point where he meets up with Goliath. We know that at the end of the story, we are going to meet a Goliath, but I wish for us to just start here. The Bible here in verse 22 says that David left his baggage in the care of the baggage keeper. So David was sent by his father to go and visit his brother. The purpose of the visit was basically to go and collect information and just to check up on them. The instruction is that take these things, take them to your brothers and bring me word from them, to ask them how they are doing and come back and tell me how they are doing. So the father then gives him loaves of bread and a bucket of cheese and an ephah of flour, so the Bible says, and he carries it to the battle site where he's going to meet his brothers. And so the Bible says that when David arrives there, he leaves his baggage in the care of the baggage keeper. It would appear that at the entry point of the battlefield, there was a man who was designated as a baggage keeper. It would appear that before you reach the battlefield, the first person you would bump into was this man that is called a baggage keeper. It appears that the work of the baggage keeper was simply to take care of baggage that was not necessary for the battle. It would appear that the work of the baggage keeper was to simply take care of things that are not necessary in the battlefield. And so David arrives, and the Bible says that he does exactly that. He leaves his baggage with the baggage keeper. He leaves things that are not going to be needed in the battle with the baggage keeper. And the Bible says that when he had left these things with the baggage keeper, then he begins to run. And my lesson this evening is simple. I want to maybe suggest to the church that I too also know a baggage keeper. And the Bible in the book of Matthew chapter 11 verse 28, this baggage keeper makes an open invitation and he says to us, come unto me all ye who are weary and heavy laden and I will give you rest. The work of the baggage keeper is essentially to just take care of those things that would burden the people in the battlefield. And I want to suggest to us this evening that life is a battlefield. And most of the times, or many a times, we fail at this life thing because we are carrying a lot of unnecessary baggage that is not needed in this battle that we are facing, and that is the battle of life. Many times we lose in the battle of life because the baggage that we are carrying is weighing heavy on our shoulders. But this evening, I want to suggest to us that I know a baggage keeper. Sometimes our progress in life is delayed and derailed because of the heaviness of the baggages that we carry. And it is unnecessary for us to carry these baggages. And I want to suggest again to the church this evening that I know a baggage keeper who made a call many years ago that all of us who are weary and heavy laden, all of us who are struggling with any sort of load, can come up to him and leave it at his feet where we will find rest. And I'm saying this evening to the church that we don't need to be carrying this luggage and this baggage that we've been carrying. In the book of Hebrews, Paul says when he writes, he says, let us lay aside every weight that so easily entangles us, and let us run with confidence this race that is set before us. Please pay attention to this fact. That when David arrives at the battlefield, the Bible says when he left his baggage with the baggage keeper, then he began to run. In other words, had he kept the baggage with him, it would have been impossible, or not necessarily impossible, it would have been hard for him to run. And I want to suggest to us that most of the time, we are derailed by the baggage that we are carrying. That we cannot run into life. Please pay attention also to the fact that when he enters, David, into the new phase of his life, he leaves the baggage that he was carrying from his previous phase of life. The Bible says that when he came to the battlefield, he leaves his baggage with the baggage keeper. In order for him to step into the battlefield, he leaves the baggage with the baggage keeper. And I want to say to all of us that sometimes in life, we get stuck where we are because we are still carrying baggage from the life that we lived in the past. And I say this evening again that it is unnecessary for us to be carrying such a baggage. The Bible says that David knew where to leave his baggage. And I am here to simply say to the church this evening that I also know a baggage keeper who has made a call for all of us to leave our baggage at his care. I know a baggage keeper who is willing to carry our baggage, who is willing to carry our troubles, who is willing to carry our headaches, who is willing to carry our heartaches. It is not necessary for us to go through life carrying the things that we are carrying when we have someone who has made a call and a commitment to carry this baggage with us. The Bible says that when David arrived at the battlefield, when David arrived on site, he left the baggage with the baggage keeper. And I'm saying to the church this evening, leave your baggage with the baggage keeper. Many of us are stuck in life because we are still carrying baggages from the past. We are struggling to enjoy the now because the yesterday is still a burden in our hearts. We are struggling to move on into the next phases of our lives because we are still carrying baggage from yesterday. We are struggling to love again because we have been hurt in the past. We are struggling to trust again because we have been betrayed in the past. And the issue here is that because we are still carrying burdens from the past, we are unable to move into the future. Our lives seems to be stuck in one place because we have just refused to let go of the burdens and the baggages of the past. But tonight, I want to suggest to the church that I also know a baggage keeper. And it is unnecessary for us to be carrying these baggages that we are carrying. Some of us are carrying baggages of hurt from the past. Some of us are carrying baggages of disappointments from the past. Some of us are carrying baggages of financial struggles. Some of us are carrying baggages of marital problems. Marital problems. We are carrying baggages of business problems. Just life is just heavy on our shoulders. But I am simply here to suggest this evening, in the middle of the week, on a week we are probably frustrated by all these things, I am simply saying it is time for you to put them down. Leave your baggage with the baggage keeper. Jesus makes a promise and he says, come unto me, all ye who are weary and are heavy laden, and all ye who labor, and I will give you rest. It is time for us to come into the presence of the baggage keeper. Before we step into any other phase of our lives, I know that some of us have lost our loved ones over this period that we are living in. Before we step into a life that we know is going to be a life without them, let us just leave our baggages with the baggage keeper that he may take care of them. And I'm saying again, it's unnecessary for us to be carrying such heavy loads in our lives when we have a man who has made a promise to carry these and make our lives a bit lighter. A story is told, as I conclude, of an old couple that was driving through a town. And as they are driving, they see a man carrying a lot of luggage, suitcases and backpacks and everything. And they are driving in a buggy. Unfortunately, it's a two-seater buggy. So they say to the man, you can climb at the back so that we relieve you of the luggage that you are carrying. Just put it down and climb into the back of the buggy. The story goes that the man then throws his stuff at the back of the buggy and he ultimately jumps into the buggy himself or onto the buggy himself and he sits there. But as they drive, the old man is puzzled by what he sees behind him as he looks at the mirror. He sees that the man whom they gave a lift to so that he may be able to relax and enjoy his journey to town, they then turn back and they see that this man had decided that even when he was on the buggy, he's going to take his luggage and put it on his back and take all other belongings of his and put them on his lap and hold on to them. And that is the nature of the Christian walk that we are walking these days, that God has made a promise to us that he will carry our burdens for us. But when we come even into his presence, instead of leaving them at the feet of Jesus, we still carry them on our backs. We still carry them on our laps. And I'm simply here to say, I know a luggage keeper, a baggage keeper, who wants to take care of the baggage that you are carrying. And I don't know what is it this evening that is bothering you. I don't know what is it that you are carrying, but I want to say to you this evening, put it down. Put it at the feet of Jesus and he will take care of them. I don't know what it is and it does not matter how big it is. I'm simply here to say I know a baggage keeper who will take care of the baggage that you carry so that you may quickly run into this life thing and do what is needed for you to do, for you to survive. Leave them at the feet of Jesus. So tonight as we pray, I ask you to think of anything and everything that bothers you, that weighs heavily on your shoulders. And with the conviction in your heart and the belief and the faith that you have in this God that you serve, let us take these burdens to the Master's throne and leave them there so that the baggage keeper may be able to take care of them. Let us pray together. Oh God and our Father in heaven, this evening we come to you heavy laden, carrying a lot of baggage, some of which we do not have to be carrying, some of which is very unnecessary and it is weighing heavy on us and it is slowing our progress in life. We are struggling to love in the marriages that we are in because we have been hurt. We are struggling to be good parents to our children. We are struggling because we were also not parented that well. We are just carrying a load of baggage that comes from the past and as a result it is affecting our lives even in the present. We've been hurt before, we've been lied to before, we've been disappointed before, we have failed before. And as a result, we are scared of stepping into the unknown and doing that which life demands us to do, and that is to live. We have stopped living because of baggages that we carry. Some of us are barely making it because of the baggage that we carry. But this evening, dear Lord, we want to leave it at your feet. And we ask you, dear Master, that may you take care of these. May you deal with them and permanently deal with them. We pray for relief. We pray for rest and true rest that is only found in you. We believe that you are a God that hears our prayers. That is why we come to you with these burdens. We believe that you are a God that answers our prayers. That is why we come to you with these burdens. And we ask you, dear Lord, I pray on behalf of everyone who is listening to the sound of my voice right now, that, dear Lord, may you meet your people at their point of need. Teach us, dear Master, to depend on you, to leave all things to your care, because you are a good and faithful God. And when you have made a promise, you are faithful to it. And we pray this believing that you are God that hears our prayers and answers them when we pray through your Son's name, and that is the name of Jesus. And it is in this name that we pray. Amen.
At the altar.
At the altar. You can tell him just how.
Oh, what he has to say.
What he